Okay. Okay, so let's continue. Okay, so this will be our third video. Okay, so we will continue talking about mechanics. Okay, so ulitin natin yung, okay, isulat ko muna dito. So mechanics, okay, so ulitin ko, it can be composed of three. Okay, so it is based on what type of body or of physical body you are referring to. Okay, so this physical body could be, or bodies rather, it can be a rigid body, okay, so it could be a deformable body, or fluids, what we call as anything that flow, whether it is liquid or gas. Okay, so ganyan lang. Okay, so ano natin? Define natin. Ano yung kaibahan itong tatlo? Okay, so we had rigid body. Okay, so mas mabuti kung ano natin, i-compare natin yung rigid body tsaka deformable body. Ito muna. Kasi itong rigid body at deformable body, they are both solids. Okay? So, we can actually form this one. So, ulitin natin. So, we can refer to this as solid. Okay, so para mas malinaw. So, mechanics. So, when we are referring to solids specifically, those solids could be considered as rigid body or deformable body. Okay? So, dito muna tayo sa mechanics of solids. Okay? Which can be so, compare natin tong dalawa, okay? They are both referring to solids, okay? There is no such thing as a rigid body na fluids. Kasi nga yung fluids, it is against its definition. When it comes to fluids, it has a tendency to flow. So, pwede siyang mag-flow. It could not be a deformable body, okay? Because deformable is something that is solid, that can be squeezed, could be extended, but not the same as fluids in which could be free flowing. Okay, so itong fluids is basically it has no strength or has a very little strength when counteracting shear stresses or shear forces. Di tulad nitong solids, okay? So, natin. Kumpara natin yung kaibahan ng rigid body tsaka ng deformable body. Okay, so, anong kaibahan nito? So, i-compare natin. Yung rigid body, okay? Okay? Simplihan lang natin yung pagka-explain. It do not deform. Or elongate. While yung deformable bodies deforms or elongate. Okay, simply ito lang. Okay, so yan yung kwan. So in reality class, okay, in reality, there is no such thing as rigid body. Okay, there is nothing absolutely rigid body. Okay, but we consider something as a rigid body if the deformation or the elongation, when it is acted upon by a force, we know that mechanics, we talk about forces and its effect on physical bodies. Kapag yung physical body mo is considered, okay? So, this is just an assumption, okay? So, if it's assumed as a rigid body, so you assume that it do not deform or elongates when it is subjected to force. For example, you are throwing rock into the air. Okay? So, when you consider it as a rigid body, so you assume at the beginning that it does not deform or elongate as a result, as a direct result of the force you applied. So, yan yung rigid body. Yung deformable bodies naman, it deforms or elongates. But somehow, it deforms or elongates elastically. Ito yung kwan. So, a deformable body is also an assumption. Why? You could actually doubt that the body is 100% elastic. Okay, ito yung ano. Okay, so when you go to your next subjects, which is mechanics of deformable bodies in the next semester, okay? So you will understand deeper what I am talking about, that a deformable bodies is there is an assumption that it deform or elongates elastically, but though in reality physical bodies actually behave in between this rigid body and deformable body or totally deformable bodies. Although a material, for example, this eraser could be the assumption that it is rigid and it will not cause significant amount of deformation when applied by force. Okay, especially if the force applied is too small, so that the deformation is negligible. Okay, the behavior of actual body is somehow between these two. It could be, it is not fully rigid, but at the same time, it is not fully deformable body. Okay, so that's why, yung P6, we could not say that it could actually perfectly model the situation. Okay? It could not perfectly give you a 100% exact solution to a problem or an exact assumption. So, both of these two are just assumptions. And in reality, it hardly exists. So, both of them are, okay? So, ganun talaga. When you model something, when you model a physical body, you need to have an assumption. Okay? So, this is what physics, okay? For example, let us say, So when what we say in actual physics problems, okay, so there is always an assumption. Okay, you cannot tell, okay, that For example, okay, so I will give another example. For example, G, the value of G, do you know that the value of G or the acceleration due to gravity is not always, although it is presented as either 9.80 or 9.81 meter per second squared, it is not always the case. There are parts in the globe or in Earth that are actually slightly lower than this. The lowest is, I think, 9.77, and the highest is around 9.826 meter per second squared. But somehow, we assume it as 9.81. So, there is nothing absolute in physics. The constants are not really constants, but they are approximate of the reality. Okay? So, you will understand it better as we go on with our lesson. So, ganyan. Ito yung kaibahan ni rigid body at saka deformable body. Okay. So, dito naman tayo sa fluids. Okay? Pag sinabi nating fluids, meron yan dalawa. It's either it can be liquid or gas. So, anong kaibahan ni liquid at ni gas? Although pareho sila na they have the capacity to flow, okay? Liquid and gas can flow into nozzles, for example. Okay? So, pag inisip nyo kasing flow, baka isipin nyo is parang tubig. Parang tubig lang. Kaya masasabi nyo yan, yung gas hindi nag-flow. Nag-flow siya. Although, gas is, most of the time, is invisible. Okay? May mga visible gas naman. Merong, okay? Depende pag nilagyan mo ng color or, okay? Okay, so liquid. It has definite shape. Okay, so meron siya, nakikita siya. Yung gas, hindi. Okay. So, yung kaibahan niya, kay rigid body and deformable body, is these two, hindi sila, wala silang definite shape. Okay? But somehow, liquid madalas nakikita. Okay? Okay? Its shape depends on its container. Okay? So, liquid, its shape depends on its container. While gas, okay, usually free. Free moving. And usually, most of gases are invisible. So, yan yung fluids. Okay? So, yan yung parts ng mechanics. Meron kang rigid body, meron kang deformable body, merong fluids, okay? Mechanics of solids, rigid body, deformable body, at mechanics of fluids, which are liquid and gas. So, that is how we divide mechanics according to its physical bodies. What about according another way of grouping mechanics? So, the another way, okay, so I will erase this one. So, the other way around is to divide it whether or not it moves or stay at rest. So, yung other term yan is yung statics. So, kayong isa natin, yung isa is dynamics. Okay. So I will erase this one. So since this is a video, pwede nyo i-replay yung portion ng video na gusto nyo hindi kayo nalinawan. Okay? Okay, so here, When we say statics, we are talking about effects, okay? So, alam naman natin yung mechanics is effects of forces. So, we got that its simplified definition is the effect of forces on physical bodies at rest. While yung dynamics, okay, branch, okay, it's as a branch of mechanics rather. So it is also a branch of mechanics. Okay, that study, okay, that study the effects of forces on physical bodies in motion. Okay, so there are two different terms. Yung isa is at rest, yung isa is at motion. So yan yung kaibahan ni statics at dynamics. Kapag at rest yung body, even though subjected siya ng force, okay, considering na yung force is not enough to move the object or the physical bodies, so we call on statics. But somehow, if the force is enough to move the object from its original position, so therefore it is in motion, so we call it dynamics. Okay, so that's the branch of mechanics according to, okay, not physical bodies already. So we got this is whether in motion, whether at rest or in motion. Okay, so you might ask, so paano, okay, so yung rigid body for solids, which is further divided into rigid body, deformable body, meron ba silang statics at dynamics? Meron. Okay? So, may I continue? Okay? So, ibig sabihin, meron din silang branch na ganun. So, for example, okay, rigid body. So, when we talk about rigid body, meron din yan dalawa. Okay? Meron ding statics dyan. Tsaka dynamics. Same with deformable body. Meron din siyang statics. Tsaka dynamics. Okay? So, meron lang konting pagkakaiba dito kay rigid. Pag solve mo, using statics, na rigid body yung assumption mo, at meron di, at etong deformable body na deformable yung assumption mo kay, ano, sa physical body mo. Also, kay fluids, meron din tayong tinatawag na fluid statics. Meron din tayong tinatawag na fluid dynamics. Okay? So, kahit anong physical body, meron siyang katumbas na study in both statics and dynamics. So, that is how we group mechanics we divide mechanics into branches depending on whether we look at it as according to the physical bodies involved or whether it is at rest or in motion.